Hey folks, this is Susie Meadows here in Central Indiana. Hope you are doing well today. This is Monday. I'm going to move the camera just a little bit here. This is Monday, May 3rd. Hey Bonnie, glad you joined me. Oh, hey Vicky. Hey neighbor, how you doing? Glad you're here. It is Monday, May 3rd. And it's 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if you're watching it at a different time, you're watching the replay, which is lovely. And just realize that if you make a comment, it may take me a smidgen of time to get back to you. So, you'll know you're live if you see the red box up in the corner. So welcome. I hope you're all doing well. I had a wonderful weekend. We had a chance to get together with the family and it was a special event. We took my mom and dad out for their 60th wedding anniversary, which is coming up. But this was a chance that the whole family could get together, as in my siblings and their kids. So it was nice. And we took them over to, hey Bonnie, we took them over to Covington Beef House. If you're from Indiana or the Midwest, you know that's a good place to go. But it was a great time spending some time with them. And then we went mushroom hunting afterwards. And if you've seen my page lately, you've seen where I found just a couple little ones. I was so tickled. Because I haven't been mushroom hunting in quite some time. But that's just me. Hey, Susan, glad you joined me. So I think we will go ahead and get going. Just a few announcements is tomorrow we get to order from this pretty new catalog. So you can see I still have it bound, so I don't open it for you too early. But you can order from this at 12:01 Mountain Time. Which for Indiana, that means it's 2 a.m. in the morning. I don't think I'll be staying up, but some people might, but I'm not going to. But since we can order this, that means today is the last day to get those last chance products. So if you're looking for them, you better go ahead and get them while you can. Okay, and we'll come back to this annual catalog. The color and contour is what we're going to use tonight, and that is in this new catalog that you can get. So I'll push that off to the side for a bit. I do want to talk a little bit about some of the local events happening here. If you're in Indiana, Central Indiana, I hope you consider joining the Paper Pumpkin, the So Cool that we got just a couple weeks ago. Remember, this is your monthly subscription kit that comes to your mailbox. We don't know what it's going to be until we get it. We sometimes get hints, but we're going to be putting these together Thursday at the library. And if you already have a kit, come join us. There's no cost. Now, if you don't have a kit, I have a few extra. So holler, and I'll get you a seat for that. And these are what you make. They're really cute cards, and they're made with kids in mind. Here's an example of the popsicle. And I have already started working on a few alternatives. Here's the kiwi popsicle, and I've used an embossing folder here. And here, I've used my blending brushes and used the playful alphabet. These are just a couple. If you're in the around... holler. I'd love to have you come. And that's Thursday. So we'll get that out of the way. And the other, what I've got going on Thursday, this class is actually on May 22nd at the library. And I used this kit last week, and it's the Mini Messages. This is the one that you stamp and you cut out and you have 19 sentiments ready to go. We're going to do a class on this at the library, and the class is on May 22nd. These are just some of the cards that I made just with some easy designer series paper, and I turned it over and I keep forgetting to show you guys the extras that I make. And so this is one side of the designer series paper, and this is the hand-pinned paper, which I love. And this is the other side of it. So really pretty. But these are examples of something that we might make. I haven't actually designed them, so we'll see. And this is some, I think, maybe some artistry paper. But Thursday, you need to let me know if you're interested. And if you, like I said, if you're local, $65. Thank you, Vicki, for letting me know, because that is not May 22nd. It is Thursday, May 20th. Thank you, lady. Yes, the 22nd is a Saturday, but this is on a Thursday night we're doing this. So Thursday night at 5:30. So here, if you're interested, holler. I'd love to have you. So these are the local. Oh, one other local event that's happening is Saturday up at Frankfort. The Frankfort Middle School, they are having a fundraiser, a spring fling craft show. And I'm going to be a vendor up there. So if you're around, come visit me. So that is Saturday. Let me see. Saturday is what? That is the 8th, and it's from 9 a.m. to 2. Now, like I said, I wanted to talk a little bit about this annual catalog. They have, I tell you, Stampin' Up's came up with some goodies. One of the goodies is that if you have, they have increased your host rewards. You know, if you had a $150 order, you got a 10%, so you got $15 free goodies. Well, now they bumped it up where at the $250 level, you get 10%, which is $25, plus you get an additional $25. So you get $50 free goodies for a $250 order. So, and that starts May 4th with this new catalog. And something else to think about, if you have quite a wish list, they have some special join. They have a special on joining where you get additional. Normally, if you pay $99, you can get $135 of goodies free. You pick whatever. Well, this time it's going to be $155. So I'll make sure I put that on the Facebook page, let you know. So, because like I said, if you're thinking, if you got a large wish list, you might want to join. You get 20% off and you get to pre-order and blah, 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 blah. Oh, so many good things. So, okay. Now we're going to get going. Hey, Jenny, how you doing? Glad you joined me. The color and contour, and I know some of you on here are demos. You're my fellow demonstrators, woohoo! And some of you may already have this, but I am really liking this. It is a photopolymer stamp set, and in the bundle you get dies, which are scalloped contours. And I tell you, the dies are what sold me. Even though I love the stamp, but this is what sold me. Look at all these. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 dies. And so you start out with a pretty scalloped. And then we'll just go in the layers. And then here you have the next size that goes right in there. And then the next size, and then this next one, and this one's fun. It's cut where you can put ribbon through there, so that's neat. And then you have a small one that fits several of the sentiments. And then, of course, a nice scallop. Look at that. It's stitched too, which is really nice. So now I compared this to the Stitch So Sweetly dies, you know, that I've used a lot. And I was just curious how they compared. And so this is an example of one of them. It's a smaller size. So it doesn't have as much of the border. But anyway, fun times. So, okay, we're going to get going. I'll quit chattering now. My goodness, I've already been chattering for 10 minutes. Can you believe it? Gabby, Gabby, Gabby. Okay, we're going to do an easy to an elaborate. So the easy one I'm going to start with is with, I've already cut, this is half a sheet of cardstock. This is the thick. I like using the thick. It really stands up. And I'm going to, since this is photopolymer, I like using a little bit of foam. This is the Stamparatus foam. And by the way, it's on clearance, $1.80. Woohoo! Love it. Okay, now, this particular card, I am going to go with, I'm going to get my stamps here. Okay, this one says, here's here for you now and in better days ahead. I'm going to use those two. And I'm going to use my really pretty flower. In fact, I'm going to use that first. I'm going to ink it up. Oops, sorry. I realize I'm shaking you a bit. Sorry about that. Okay, and I'm going to put this right in the middle. Press down. There we go. And I'm going to do here for you now at the top. Make sure. Yep. Right there. Okay. And now we're going to use and in better days ahead. There we go. Perfect. And there we go. We have our easy card. Look at how easy that was. Now, let's bump this up a little bit. So, to bump it up, I need to clean a few stamps. So, we'll clean the big guy. There we go. We'll clean that one's ready to go for me. And, okay. I am going to, I don't know if you have seen the new in colors. They are the 21 through 23 in colors. You know, we get five of them each time. And the colors are polished pink, soft succulent, pale papaya, and I'm going to use the fresh freesia and evening evergreen. So I'm going to start with my evening evergreen. Get my memento out of the way. Pop this baby open. Okay. Get my big guy. And I'm just going to ink him up. There we go. Okay. Get this right here in the middle. And I'm going to go with the same design, guys. But I'm going to bump it up by adding other colors of ink and paper. There we go. So that's our evergreen. Now I need my sentiments. I'm going to use the same one. So here's my here to you. Got to turn it over so it's up right side up. Here for you now. And I really like this evergreen. It is, it really, evening evergreen. It's I sort of look at it as a neutral, like my blacks or my basic grays. There we go. It's just a nice dark color, and I think it looks really sharp. Okay, get that out of the way. Now we're going to add some color. Like I said, this is fresh freesia, so I'm going to color in my flowers. I'm glad you like that, Marie, this bundle. I agree. There's a lot of versatility with it. And so now these are supposed to be artsy-fartsy, so they don't totally match. You can try as long as you want, but they will not match. Just to let you know. So, okay. Now, we have this leaf, and I think I'm going to use it. I'm going to use the evening evergreen, and it doesn't match anything, just so you know. Get it inked up really well. So there we go. It just adds some greenery, so very nice. There we go. Okay, so make sure my hands are clean because I'm going to pick up white. See, look, I've got ink, ink, ink. I'm going to wash my hands real quick on the chamois. Because otherwise, there's a good chance I'll get things everywhere. Okay. Yep. Doing better. Okay. Now, we're just bumping this up. And so, I'm going to use my multi-purpose liquid glue. Just get a little, just enough on there to, there we go. And we're going to center it. There we go. So here we've bumped it up. Here, it looks very dignified in the black and white. And here we've added a little bit of color. Now let's bump this baby up some more. So we'll put each of these on that side. We'll get the stamp set out of the way. Okay, this next one, I got to think through what I was going to do here. I've got to pull some goodies over. I've got my dimensionals. I got some, we're going to use some bling. Okay, we are going to start with a card base. And I have already cut this out. This is one of the dies. We're going to go like here. We're going to go here, and we're going to use some ribbon. So, first of all, we're going to stamp our image. So, move these out of the way, and once again, I'm going to use my Evening Evergreen. Where did I lay my stamp? Here we go. You know, this time I'm going to start with a sentiment, and this sentiment is, thank you for everything. And I'm going to start and put it down here in the corner. And that's going to help me for my placement of where my flower is. There we go. And so I'm going to offset my flower just a little bit like that. Straight down. Let the ink transfer. Perfect. Good, good, good. Now I'm going to color. And I'm going to use this once again and my Fresh Freesia. And you know, I want to look like, I want to see what it looks like stamped off. Because if I don't like it, I can always stamp it again. Oh, it's not very dark at all, is it, that time? We're going to stamp it again. We're going to go full strength. I wasn't sure. I have used this color a lot. I did some swap cards, and so I used it a lot. Okay, get that out of the way here. Get our paper back. Now what I want to do is, we're going to let, this is drying. We're going to move it over, if I can pick it up. Okay. Okay, right here is where we're going. I want to use this open weave ribbon in Fresh Freesia. There you go. It's upside down. Hey, Doris, glad you joined me from chilly Wisconsin. Oh, dear. It has actually warmed up here, and it has been spring. In fact, we had showers today, and I, like I said, I went mushroom hunting yesterday. I had pants on, and I just about did not need to have them on. In other words, I just about needed shorts. Let me clarify. Yes. What I'm doing, I've got this so I know where I want it. So right here's where, and you know, before, let me see, do I want that on top or underneath? I want it on top. So that means I need to glue this down. So I could bump it up, but I think I'm going to glue it down. Hey, Missy, glad you joined me, lady. Okay, let's get this centered back in here. I am working on the elaborate card. I started with an easy, I bumped it up, and now I'm working on the elaborate. So I'm going to bring this over here and just thread it through. Yep, that's where I want it. Yep, looks good. Okay, I'm going to cut it. I have the heck of a time tying when it's loose like this. So for me, I have found it is better that I tie a bow and add it. But to get my ribbon down, I'm just going to use a glue dot on each end. One of those mini glue dots. There we go. Get it back where it's, here we go, and there. Oops, I haven't got this guy down yet. There we go. Okay, now I have already tied a bow, if I could find it. Well, first thing, we're going to close up some inks. This is dangerous having ink pads open around me, because I've been known to accidentally throw things. Yes, so, okay. Oh, here is, see, I knew I had a ribbon. I had a bow somewhere. So once again, I'm going to use a glue dot. This is just how I do it, guys. You might be great at tying bows on the fly, but I'm not. I tell you, I struggle, so I have found I make life just a smidgen easier for myself and just do a bow otherwise. Oh, now doggone it. Try it a little bit more. Look at that, I still didn't do it. Okay. There we go. Okay, get all this out of the way now. There we go. Oh, my glue dot had stuck to my foam pad. Well, okay, now I am ready to put it on here. Okay, so I'm gonna bump it up. I want some elevation. So where are my dimensionals? They're underneath my bling, I remember. Okay, got a new pack out. So we'll put one on each corner. And I like to have some, I like to really make sure my ribbon stays down. And I'm going extra. I'm adding just a few extra. Don't have to have this many, but I've got them. And, you know, when it goes through the, at the mail, at the post office, you know, many times they're metered. And so sometimes if they aren't balanced, you get a card that's counter-whoppered. I just about put that upside down. Holy cow. Here we go. Okay. Perfect. There we go. Now, we must use some bling. Okay, guys, last week this was a full packet of in-color jewels, and you can see what I have left. I've used all my all but three soft succulents. I've used all but seven of my fresh freesia, my evening evergreen. I've been using them. Okay, so I'm going to, we can go with, well, I don't know what color we're going to go with, but hey, thanks for sharing, Susan. I appreciate that. You know, we are going to, I like these because they're faceted. They're pretty. I think we need to put a dark evergreen there. We need to go with so many possibilities, you know. Oh, come on with me. Work with me here. Okay, and I'm going to put a pretty fresh freesia up there. And I'm going to use a smaller one since we're going up. I'm going to put one right there. And we're going to use more. Like I said, this is the elaborate card. So I want some more. I've used the evergreen as to ground me a little bit. So we'll use another big dude, and I think we're going to put him here. And I want another one down here. You know, what about the dark evergreen? There we go. I am so random, there probably should be a better idea, but that's just the way it goes. Okay, so that's my bling. So let me pull these babies out here. So in conclusion, wrap this baby up, get our jewels. Obviously, you can tell what I'm going to be ordering tomorrow, some jewels. Okay, so this was... by the way, this is the host code if you're interested in ordering anything. But this was our easy card. Just straight out black and white, but very elegant. And this one we added the same design, but we added some color using that fresh freesia. And here, hey Mary, glad you joined me. Here we bumped it up to totally elaborate by using two different dyes, ribbon, using some of our in-color jewels. So, oh, now see, I had this and I was going to use it. This is a pretty, it makes a pretty, pretty, well, let me just show you what it does. I remembered. Here's some cards I made earlier. I finally remembered. This is one of the elaborate ones I made, and this is what that stamp does. It gives you a pretty little splattering. And this one uses, this is from this bundle's dies, and so is this. And that's that leaf I just added, gave it some interest. Here I used a little bit of the soft succulent open weave, and these are the Genial Gems. And as you can tell, I've used a lot of the green, the soft succulent. I've really liked those. So this was one of the cards that I've done getting ready for this. Oh, and this ribbon, I need to show you that. This is new too. You can get this tomorrow. Woven ribbon, and it is pale papaya. I like this ribbon. So it's really soft and easy to tie. So this was another card that I made earlier. I don't know, we'll put it here and put our gems there. And then here's one with this other flower that is in the stamp set. And here I used polished pink and fresh papaya. And this is the Taylor Tag Punch. And you've seen me make a border on these before. And then here I stamped and actually die cut this one out and added some more bling, got some jewels there. So here you go, gang. Here is our easy to elaborate card. Hope you enjoy this. I tell you, this is a great bundle. You might consider getting it if you're not, because I love the dies. The dies are going to go with anything. And then, of course, there's nice sentiments. So that was one of my elaborates, and this was another one. Okay, I think that's it, gang. Let me see. I'll be back on here next Monday, May 10th at 5 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Who knows what I'll be working on, but I'll definitely make sure I'll be with some of the new goodies because, you know, this new catalog, it goes live at 12:01 Mountain Time tonight. So, yeah, so you might consider because there's all kinds of goodies. I can't open it. Yes. So, hey, hope you guys are doing well. Thank you so much. I appreciate you guys coming and watching and commenting. It really means a lot to me, gang. So be safe, and I hope you get to do some crafting. And I will talk to you later. Toodles. Bye-bye.